Reagan, and today I'm here to do a little bit of a different video than I normally do on my channel. It's gonna be a bit of an evaluation, if you will. Today I'm gonna be talking through the ugliest books on my bookshelf, in my opinion. The funny thing about this video is I was collecting the books that I found to be the ugliest. Most of them are like my favorite books, which I feel like is a very interesting, like, dichotomy. Like, these books I'm never gonna get rid of, even though I think they are the ugliest books on my bookshelf. So, you know, that's an interesting thing to think about. Also, in many ways, this is an evaluation of how fantasy might want to look into how to make their covers less ugly. Because they kind of all fall into the same traps of like weird faces, really dark brooding colors, and like terrible spines. But anyway, without further ado, let's chat through, in my opinion, some of the ugliest books on my shelf. The first one is a bit disappointing because I think the first one is actually really good. Hold up, I'll show you. Here's the first one, Finnegan of the Rock, really nice jewel tone, you know, and illustrations. It's not so bad. But then they redid the covers, and now we have something like this, like a zoom up of some guy's face, a sword, and very bad font, like Sanskrit font. And this guy's like wearing eyeliner. This character would never wear eyeliner. And the thing is, it's like, this is my favorite book in this series, one of my favorite YA fantasy books of all time. I love this book. I would love to be putting it on display, but like, I can't do that to my apartment guests. This eye follows you everywhere. He's like smizing, like Tyra Banks taught him how to pose for this book cover. It's disappointing, to say the least. These could use with a bit of repackaging, relove. But again, if you haven't read this series, read it. It's amazing. Don't let the weird face shy you away from experiencing a really wonderful book series. Flipping right along to actually a recently repackaged series, which I think is just not very good, is the Tamara Pierce Immortals series. And honestly, these aren't terrible necessarily, but like, they're also not very cute. I mean, there's just like this badger, this like dragon head. I just feel like the illustrations could perhaps have been a little better. These feel very like late 90s fantasy, and these are not, these like are newer covers. And again, it's like, this is just like a wing. It's just a wing, there's nothing else, it's just a wing. I just feel like they missed an opportunity to have like beautifully illustrated covers. I mean, this is Tamara Pierce, like people are gonna buy these books, but instead we got like wolf head with frat boy LED lights in the background. Next up I'm putting on the list because I feel like this author, since this series, has had some really amazing, like some of the best covers out there. I feel like Le Verbre has some of the most beautiful covers. I'm talking specifically about like The Diviners. I mean, that book series is one of the most beautifully packaged series of all time, but then we have Great and Terrible Beauty, and again we just have like this trend of the face and the corset and the font. And this, it just, it feels, to me this looks like a vampire novel, and it's not at all, pretty much. I mean, like, it has paranormal magical elements, but this is not a vampire novel, but I feel like if you looked at it, I feel like if you look at a store and saw what this is about, I feel like you might think it's a period vampire novel. Especially because of her name font. It is, to me, that's what it looks like. Which, I love a vampire novel, but that's not what this is. And then we have one of the worst repackagings of all time. That being said, there are some really amazing things about these redesigned covers. I mean, Sabatier specifically wanted to have characters and like book cover actors that looked like the character she was writing about. Love that we have a series that has individuals from the actual culture and actually look like the characters that are being written about on this book. I think that's super important. That being said, I think they deserve better than this because this cover could have been a lot better and also had that really important change enabled, if that makes sense. It's like, I see what you guys are trying to do and I laud that, and that should definitely be what should have happened, but like, also, couldn't we have made this look better? Like, guys. I'm talking about an Ember in the Ashes series. I love this series and I love our main character on here, but like, I think the color is weird, I think the font is weird, I think the white is weird. I think they could have just done so much better of a job with these repackaging of these novels. I'm down with the repackaging, I just think this could have been executed much better, so I'm a little disappointed by the execution of it. If anything, I really just don't, I especially just dislike like the color and the white, because the next ones are blue and then it's green and then it's yellow. I just think it just doesn't look very good. Next up, we have a study of early 2000s fantasy with the Study series. See what I did there? I mean, these aren't terrible, but like they're also not good by any means. I mean, we have like an arm peeking around a staircase, just a curtain, like nothing else, purely a curtain and some font. Oh wait, no, actually that's not a curtain. Those are legs. Look, there's feet. So we have an arm, some feet, and a back. I don't know, I just feel like the colors are nice. I appreciate like the range of colors, but ultimately I just don't think these are that good. I think something a little more beautiful. I mean, the style of like this almost like ancient painting is cool, but I mean, we have feet on the second one. Feet. The next book is on the list because the UK editions of these are beautiful, extraordinary. I want to buy them, but they're not floppy, so it's like, eh. Even the UK's like special edition of this book, by far and away, leagues better than the United States version. And I'm talking about The Name of the Wind by Patrick Rothfuss. I mean, this is like a classic cover, this guy in the cloak with the tree and the blue, but like, let's also be honest with ourselves, this is not cute. This isn't cute in any way, especially compared to the UK edition. I mean, look at it, it's beautiful. And even the special anniversary edition in the United States is like scary. It's scary. It has like this scary face on it. Do you see that? And then I mean like this is cool, but like that's scary. I'm just thinking like, again, just compared to what the UK got, we got a little short change is all I'm trying to say, because those are beautiful and these are like. And the last series I'm gonna talk about is the Black Prism series. I just think these are like all right. I mean, I just don't think they're very eye-catching. I think they're really dark and moody in a way that's like not good. I also wanna shout out that I think these books were also just poorly designed as a paperback. Whereas The Name of the Wind is ugly, at least it has this amazing like readability. The Black Prism series doesn't. It has this like terrible construction of this paperback that makes it really hard to read. It's like awkward to hold. It's awkward, like it's long, so you don't wanna like crack the spine if you don't want to. It's very difficult. I just feel like it's not a very good construction. Like it's not very cute. I don't like the spine. It's really dark, not a lot of color definition. And it's also just like not very easy to read, which I feel like is the biggest crime here. I wouldn't mind if the book was so ugly, but at least if it was easy to read, I would be interested. I would be much, much happier is what I'm trying to say, but like also they're super ugly. These get more like vibrantly bad as the series continues. Oh, I have one more. I have one more, hold on. Kingdom of Ash. This might be a bit of a surprise, but like I think this yellow is so garish. It does not match the rest of the series at all. It sticks out like a sore thumb on my bookshelf. I love the illustration a lot on the front and the back, but I think this selection of this like gold yellow foiling, not even like gold, it's yellow. It's like urine colored yellow. It's just not good. I wish they just kept it to a cooler tone to match the rest of the books on my shelf. It just doesn't look good with everything else. Alrighty guys, those are the ugliest books on my bookshelf in my opinion. Fun thing about this video is it is really honestly just full of my opinions. I'm not trying to insult anyone. In fact, most of the books, if not all of the books I talked about are some of my favorite books ever. So it even hurt me a little bit to talk bad about them, but someone needed to say it. They're not cute covers, but I will hold on to them for the rest of my life and proudly display them despite that. Because, you know, it's about what's on the inside. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know down below some of your favorite books that you also hate the covers of, as I would love to know. Anyway, see you guys later. Bye!